The final event of the session is the men's 4x200 freestyle relay. This is going to be intense. That's the way they line up. Germany, United States, Italy, Great Britain in pole position. Just got a glimpse of the world record. 6:58.55. It's a colossal world record from the American quartet. Phelps and Lochte were both in that team.
Brazil comes out to take lane number 8. Scheffer will lead them off.
Lane one for Germany. Not fancied for a medal. No great tradition in 4x200 freestyle swimming, although they've had some great individual performers from Germany in the past.
Here are the Swiss team. Djokovic will be their lead-off swimmer. USA into lane number 2. Oh, something you don't see every day.
No, they're the defending champions. Gold in the 4x1. What can they do in the 4x2? But they're over, way over in lane 2.
And here are the Russian Olympic Committee team. Malyutin will lead it off. Rylov's in there as well. So they've got some talent. But they are in lane 6. A lane can get you a gold medal. It doesn't matter what lane. I would have to think that the centre of the pool, Great Britain, are going to get it done.
And in lane 3, Italy, and they've got their eyes on a medal. Silver in their 4x1 freestyle team in Tokyo 2020. They're bronze medal winners in the Europeans, fourth at the World Championships. Can they upgrade that at the Olympics?
Here are the Australians. Alex Graham will be their lead-off swimmer. Tommy Neal has come into this final team, so too Kyle Chalmers.
And in pole position in for Great Britain, the favourites here after the gold and silver performances of Tom Dean and Duncan Scott in the individual. Scheffer from Brazil, as we picked out, the bronze medal winner in that race. And for Great Britain, the Olympic champion, Tom Dean, will lead them out. They're going to be anchored by the Olympic silver medalist, Duncan Scott. How does that sound? James Guy and Matthew Richards in the engine room for this. And what a history this team has got. World champions in 2017, silver medalists in Rio, silver in the European Championships, and James Guy himself is a world champion in an individual event. He has got 7 golds in the Europeans, 4 golds in the Worlds, and the silver in Rio for James Guy. So there is experience and quality throughout this quartet. There's the newly crowned Olympic champion in the individual 200 freestyle, Tom Dean. Great Britain swimming in 4. Alexander Graham will lead off Australia in 5, and keep your eyes closer to us on Fernando Scheffer from Brazil in lane 8. The final of the men's 4x2 freestyle team. Here we go. Great Britain chasing a 3rd gold medal in Tokyo 2020.
Kieran Smith from the USA just forcing it out ahead of the field at the moment. No prizes won at the 25-metre mark, but he certainly got himself off to an okay start. Great Britain just coming through as well. That's Tom Dean. As James Parrick said, he has won the Olympic Games gold medal in this 200 metres freestyle. And if you remember that 200 freestyle, he came through in the final stages. So don't be panicked if he's not there in the first 100 metres, because the second half of his 200 free will be very, very good. And of course, it takes 4 swimmers to win this 4x200 freestyle relay. So they have to put it together and they have to be safe on the changeovers.
Well, the United States with something to prove. Kieran Smith finished fifth in the individual final on a 145. So he's going to be there or thereabouts. Scheffler, remember, third in that final for Brazil in lane eight, but now on the charge. In the middle of the pool with the red hat is Great Britain. Still in the lead, though, the United States. This is a great swim from Kieran Smith. Can he hang on in the final 50?
Well, the occasions that they've held this 4x200 freestyle relay, the USA has not lost a gold medal at the Olympics very often. They've won it on 17 occasions. They have a great sense of history when it comes to the relays. They want to win this. Kieran Smith has put in a blinder of a first leg. Let's see what time he goes on the wall.
144.74. Tom Dean won the individual in 144.2. Tom Dean a little bit off his pace, 145.7. It's not the best of starts for Great Britain. They won't mind this. Talent across the quartet, and it does take four to win the medals. James Guy now in for Great Britain. Great experience in James Guy. He's an individual world champion in his own right from 2017, and here he comes in to do the job for the relay, as he has done so often over the last six, 7 years.
James was very good in the heats of the 4x200 freestyle relay. That's James Guy. He's already bridged this gap with the American. This is Drew Kibler that is in the water for the USA. Kyle Chalmers, Olympic champion in the 100 metres freestyle, is in the water for Australia. He also won the trials in the 200 freestyle, but elected not to race it here at Tokyo. Great underwater by the Australian, but James Guy is absolutely motoring.
Guy on the charge. In my mistake, he's a world champion in the 200 freestyle, not the 400, and that was in Kazan 2015 for those who are following statistics. James Guy now doing the job, as he's so often done, bringing Great Britain back on level terms with the United States. Drew Kibler in for the Americans, and James Guy on 50 metres to go now on this, is breathing to the left, looking at the Americans. He's eaten into the lead. They're neck and neck at the moment, the best of the rest behind the two leaders is possibly Australia in five, with possibly the Russians in six. This is going to be very tight.
So coming in for the changeover for the third swimmer, James Guy. I think we'll have a change in lead here. Very quick on the changeover from Great Britain. Very quick. Matthew Richards into the water. And Australia are sitting in fourth. The Russian Olympic Committee team got into the wall on third on that changeover. And the USA has Zach Apple in the water. Apple. He had a fantastic swim in the 4x1 split. What's he got in the 200?
And anchoring the Americans to victory on that occasion, Apple is in the engine room of this American quartet, looking across at Great Britain in the form of Matt Richards. Kyle Chalmers has done the job for Australia, putting them into contention. It's Zach Insetti in for the Australians, and they've just got their noses in front of the Italians. You can't count out Italy. Had a terrific heat swim, and they're three in a line behind the leaders. They're at the midpoint of this third quarter of the relay. Great Britain and the United States lead the way.
Great underwater by Matthew Richards. Zach Apple has tried to bridge the gap in the first 100 metres. We'll see if he pays for that in the second 100 metres. But the intention underwater of that 100 metre turn from Matthew Richards, and he's taken over again. There was only 3 100s separating them at that last turn. And now the margin's bigger. What a great relay swim by Matthew Richards.
Fantastic around the turns. You could see him bounce off the wall, hammer the underwater fly leg kick, and the Americans are fading. This is just a commitment too far for America. They're going to be overhauled by four teams. The Americans falling apart as Great Britain strike for home in the form of Duncan Scott. There's no way Great Britain are going to lose this. Scott, the individual silver medal winner in the 200 freestyle, is going to bring Great Britain home on a march. The best of the rest now is Russia in lane six. Australia in five. The Americans are finding themselves in fifth position now. Italy in fourth.
Well, Great Britain won this in 1908 when they first introduced the 4x200 freestyle relay. This is going to be a momentous occasion for the Great Britain team. But look at this race on for the silver and the bronze. There's another 100 to go. You don't want to be trying to win it at the 700 metre mark. In the water for the USA is Townley Haas, trying to pick back up after Zach Apple absolutely fatigued in the final stages of his leg.
Stefano Ducola in for Italy. They're in lane three, battling with Australia. And Australia's Thomas Neal in the anchor leg for the Australians. But Russian Olympic Committee hanging on with Galyuk in the anchor leg. Great Britain now in pole position, though. It's a procession for Great Britain to gold.
Well, just one lap to go. Duncan Scott hits the wall, has a look, he knows. Stays underwater of that choppy, drag-filled space off the turns. And look at him head home. And look at this race for the silver and bronze.
Nothing in it. It's going to be gold for Great Britain. They're celebrating already. A procession for Duncan Scott. And look, the world record right at his fingertips. In the closing stages, the battle behind him is between Australia and the Russian Olympic Committee. Great Britain strike gold. 6:58.58.
3/100ths of a second, they missed the world record by. They win the gold, though. What a swim to Great Britain.
Jimmy Guy is in tears. He can barely contain the emotion. What a day for Great Britain. It's the third gold medal for the British team. I was wondering if it was a world record. It wasn't. 6:58.58, though. 3/100ths behind. The Russian Olympic Committee in second and Australia in third. 3/100ths behind the silver medal for the Australians. And the Americans have to settle for four. Look at the celebrations for Great Britain. History in the making. Finally, Olympic gold for James Guy and Great Britain.
Oh, that's fantastic. The emotion. They targeted this 4x2, didn't they? They wanted it.
For many years. This has been a team in development for, 8 years?
USA shattered, finishing out of the medals.
Well,
incredible.
There's only one team celebrating on the pool back there. And that's Great Britain. This is how they won it. Look, the Americans with a huge lead after the first leg. And Tom Dean will be thinking, look, I've done my job, I know, but if I'd given an extra quarter of a second to this team, we would have set the world record. That would have been the perfect swim. It wasn't to be, it doesn't matter.
World records get broken. Gold medals last forever. Britain have claimed the gold medal in the 4x200 freestyle relay. As we do a replay victory lap with Great Britain, it just was clinical. And the emotion of the gold medal.
Now that's James Guy on the right of the picture. Barely contain himself. Duncan Scott bringing it home. History for Great Britain behind him. Second for the Russian Olympic Committee. Just holding off Australia for third in the minor medals. And look at this solidarity. Team spirit. They knew this was on the cards.
The Americans have never missed the medal podium in the 4x200 freestyle relay history, except the 1980 Olympic Games that they weren't there for.
It's an amazing statistic. America off the medal podium for the first time, then as Great Britain celebrate victory. Russian Olympic Committee and Australia with the minor medals behind a monster swim from the British quartet. Well, they're staying on the pool deck. They don't want to leave, do they? They know they're going to have to. Duncan Scott all smiles. James Guy there just leading them home. And I wonder how he's going to hold it together when they get to the cameras and the live link up back to home and so many people watching, celebrating back in Great Britain for this quartet. Everybody knows this was a chance for gold. And for Great Britain, the first time, is it the first time they've ever been on the top step of the podium? I believe so.
1908.
Sorry, 1908. I wasn't listening. So here we are, the victory ceremony for the men's 4x2 freestyle relay, and it's Great Britain. A historic day for the British. It's their third gold medal of Tokyo 2020. just 3/100ths away from the world record. And what a story that would have been if Britain had won gold and the world record. It wasn't to be on this occasion, but as we know, records are broken, medals last forever. Tom Dean, James Guy, Matt Richards and Duncan Scott. Dean and Scott, the gold and silver medal winners of the individual 200 freestyle, which meant that Britain would head into this as strong favourites, and they won by miles in front of the rest of the field. James Guy himself, a former world champion on the 200 freestyle. What quality and talent through the field.
The medal presenters being announced. Always an IOC member accompanied by a FINA Bureau member.
Accompanied by Bureau member, FINA, Qatar.
So the medals first will go to Australia. Alexander Graham, Kyle Chalmers in the engine room, bringing Australia into contention. Zach Inserte following and Thomas Neal anchoring and doing a job to hang on behind the Russian Olympic Committee and hold off the United States and so on.
Alexander Graham, Kyle Chalmers, Zach Inserte, Thomas Neal.
So the Australian men take the bronze. They claimed a gold in 2000 in front of a home crowd. And then medals again in 04, 08, missed it in 2012 and 2016. Back on the victory dais. And the Russian Olympic Committee team take the silver.
Magnificent swim for the Russian team. Silver medal. They held off Australia, they held off Italy, they held off the United States.
It's a nice touch, isn't it? The swimmers presenting each other with their medals.
There was a directive saying, please don't do that, but I don't think the athletes are going to pay any attention at all. So the medals have been awarded, and now the flowers and the mascot, usually the, you know, whatever representative figure it is for whatever games it is or major championships. Good result for the Russian Olympic Committee. That was Malyutin, Girev, Rylov and Dovgalyuk. But here it is. The story is about Great Britain. What a moment for Great Britain, and what a moment for Tom Dean, James Guy, Matthew Richards and Duncan Scott. That's the order that we see them in from left. Tom Dean, the British following the orders. They're putting the medals around their own necks. That's James Guy, that's Matthew Richards, and then Duncan Scott with the gold medal that he's been so looking forward to at the Olympic level. And there they are. How good must it feel to share this with your team and with your nation? Calum Jarvis also a huge part of that.
Duncan Scott's split in that final leg was 1:43.45. Unbelievable.
It's a colossal swim from Duncan Scott. As we get a chance to listen to the national anthem of Great Britain for the third time at Tokyo 2020. and gold medal for Great Britain. History being made then for the British quartet. Tom Dean is based at the National Centre in Bath, alongside Jimmy Guy. He's also down there. Calum Jarvis, who swam in the heats, is also there, and Duncan Scott up in Scotland at the Performance Centre in Stirling, who produced such terrific talent. So congratulations to David McNulty, the coach down in Bath, and a lot of the British are a little bit overcome by this, and it has been a huge national effort across perhaps 8 years as Great Britain focused its attentions on success at the relays, and it's delivered gold finally in Tokyo 2020. They've been through Europeans, stood up to the podium there, stood on the podium at the World Championship level. Individual athletes have to be good enough to be able to deliver gold on an individual level. They've stood on the podiums. They've become world and now Olympic champions themselves, Olympic world medal winners, and now they've put it all together and knocking on the door of the world record.
Their fastest performance prior to coming into Tokyo 2020 was a 7.01.70. They were sitting at the fourth best performing nation in history. Well and truly gone under 7 minutes at 6.58.58. So from 7.01.70 to 6.58.58. And these splits, oh, they were quite fantastic, weren't they? We saw that the Olympic champion Tom Dean went 1:45.72 off the start. James Guy went 1:44.40. Matthew Richards 1:45.0.